Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to FTC Monday Night CAW. We're live here in Portland, Oregon, in front of 18,420 strong. This is our go-home show to our biggest show, No Mercy. And tonight, we got a lot of action for you. The King of Wrestling, Billy Paz, goes one-on-one with the phenomenal Travis Delena. The winner of this match will go on to face the Kid for the Cruiserweight Championship at No Mercy. Both of these teams have had a lot of success over the last few weeks. And tonight, Ryan Carroll and Sako 105 take on Tony Free and Triple D. And the winner of this match will go on to face Southern Comfort for the FTC Tag Team Championships at No Mercy. It's a rematch from last week. Red Belt Reggie Tillar going one-on-one with the executive Mr. Mugg. Reggie doesn't like how Mugg won the match last week, and tonight he wants revenge. The FTC Hardcore Champion Texas Tommy is in the building tonight. He's been gone over the last few weeks examining the Hardcore Division, and tonight you can bet he has a lot to say in front of this crowd. Later tonight, Hardcore Champion Texas Tommy going one-on-one with a mystery opponent. We'll find out who it is later. You can bet that the Hardcore Champion has a lot on his mind for tonight. And it's our main event. Made by the champion at the end of last week's episode, Von Hollywood going one-on-one with the Great One, The Rock. And you can bet that Von Hollywood needs this momentum heading into No Mercy. Oh, and this crowd knows this theme real well. They're on their feet right now. It's the FTC Hardcore Champion, Texas Tommy.
Time no see. How's everybody doing tonight? It's good to see Portland is still as live as it was before my absence, if not even more. Now, I've been gone for the last few weeks, but that don't mean I haven't been watching the show. This roster here in FTC has been expanding a lot lately, and I've been scouting new talent for our hardcore division. There are two men I'd like to introduce to the ring at this time. Both advanced to the second round of the number one contendership tournament, and their respective matches really impressed me. And now you're all gonna see them go one-on-one in a 5-minute hardcore Ironman match. The man with the most decisions after 5 minutes will go on to No Mercy and face me for this FTC Hardcore Championship. So, without any further ado, let me introduce David Starr and Mitchell Gunn.
What an announcement by the Hardcore Champion, making his way to the ring. From Los Angeles, California, David Starr. And his opponent from Seattle, Washington, Mitchell Gunn. You see these men face to face. Oh, what? You can cut the tensity with a knife right here. And our champion's leaving the ring. What respect shown here in this hardcore division. Oh man, and this opening contest is underway. 5-minute Ironman match. The man with the most falls after 5 minutes is going to be the number one contender for the hardcore championship at No Mercy. And look at Mitchell Gunn. 1, 2, 3. Whoa! That early, folks. That early into the contest, Mitchell Gunn picked up a pinfall right there. That could have a lot to do with the outcome of this contest right here. Oh my goodness, and it looks like David Starr is pissed off about that, and he just throws a flurry of shots with a drop kick right there, and every single one of them connecting, and he knocks Mitchell Gunn to the outside of the ring. I don't believe that. That was in the first 15, 20 seconds. He hits a pinfall, and oh my god, what a nice diving flip right there by David Starr to the outside. And just like I predicted, it's not going to take long for this match to get hardcore. David Starr bashing Mitchell Gunn's face. Oh my god, face first into the pole just after he went face first into that barricade right there. This is absolutely crazy action right here, folks. And oh my god, Northern Lights suplex. You know, there's pinfalls anywhere, especially in this hardcore action. So I think David Starr really needs to Oh, he's going to look to get him. Oh, smashes. I thought he was going to throw him into the ring right there. He doesn't have that much time. He needs to get a pinfall. David Starr has three and a half minutes, just about to get two pinfalls, because that's what he needs to go on to No Mercy to be the number one contender for the Hardcore Championship. And now these two men taking it to the outside, that is what the Hardcore Division is all about. And, oh man, bringing it right back out. That's crazy right there by David Starr. What's he going for? Back first. Oh man, these two men have got to be making Texas Tommy proud right here. He's in the back watching this action go down. And, you know, both of these men have really been impressing us so far with their action, especially here on the outside, going back and forth, not really having too much momentum. Oh my God, face first with those stairs. That has got to hurt. And he's got the steel, he's got the ring bell. He throws the bell in, hits him right in the lower intestine. That has got to hurt right there, folks. And, oh my God, what a counter. Oh my God, the Russian leg sweep. Unbelievable right there. David Starr, what could he be going for? Snap suplex on the bell. Oh my God. And you can bet that the more damage that these two men inflict to each other, the easier it's going to be for Texas Tommy to retain his championship. And as you can see, the time is only getting smaller on the clock. David Starr, connects him with a couple of shots with that ring bell. He just has a little over 2 minutes to score two pinfalls. And, I bet it's not going to be hard for him to get one pinfall real soon, because he's been inflicting a lot of damage lately. And there's all kinds of weapons in the ring. You know, this match is getting insane. Oh, my God. He just slammed his back and the back of his neck on the... Oh, my goodness. Right on the bell. Disgusting by David Starr right there. And what's this? Oh, my God. He's setting up. No. Oh, my God. The starburst on the steel stairs. What a lethal combination. One. Two, three, David Starr ties it up with 1:40 left on the clock. Oh my God, how is Mitchell Gunn gonna... all David Starr has to do is get him on the ground one more time and pin him one more time, and this match is over. Well, not that much, but, you know, you gotta go another 1.5 pretty much, but God, this match has gone crazy so far. He's been tied, just a little over 1 minute left on the clock, and what the hell else is gonna go down? Oh my God, suplex onto both of those weapons. This is absolutely brutal. What will happen if this match ends in a tie? It absolutely could. I don't think Texas Tommy would be obliged to, defend his championship. I think he could just kick it if he wanted to. And as we see David Starr sending him into the corner. Oh my God, no. Not a tornado. Tornado DDT on the steel steps. Hey, that could be it right there. And the clock is ticking down. Less than 1 minute left. Oh my God. He should pin him right here. That's a rookie mistake right there by David Starr. But he hasn't been in FTC that long. So, you know, you can't exactly, you know, be too harsh about it. But, oh, he hit hard. The back of his head hit hard. And it only takes something small like that for the momentum to swing in his direction. But just when I say something like that, Mitchell Gunn gets knocked over the top to the outside. And oh, he misses big with the splash. Only 10 seconds left on the clock. What's going to happen? These men are still fighting. Oh, 4, 3, 2, 1. Tied 1-1. Literally fought to the last seconds. We hear the music. There he is, Texas Tommy. What the hell is going to happen here, ladies and gentlemen?
You boys are a couple of fighters, no doubt. You're forcing me to make a heck of a decision. Neither of you won the match, so that means that neither of you will have to worry about qualifying. The match at No Mercy will be a triple threat, one fall to a finish. Hope you two can handle it from here. I have a big match later tonight and don't know my opponent yet. Good luck to the both of you.
Let's take a look at this matchup. In the first 15 seconds, Mitchell Gunn scored a roll-up. Not the first pinfall of the match, but it didn't take long for David Starr to unleash the inner wildness within him. He totally took it out on Mitchell Gunn. He made this match real hardcore, real early in it. And, they still went back and forth. You know, even when it was, you know, toward halfway in the match, he dropped him on his head. The starburst, 1, 2, 3, that move puts everyone away. And literally until the last seconds of this match, he What a fight by those two. Well, after the break, Billy Paz goes one-on-one with Travis Delena. Both of these men have been really impressive lately, and tonight, we'll find out who's going to face the Kid for the FTC Cruiserweight Championship at No Mercy. And it's the rematch from last week. The Red Bell Reggie Tillar going one-on-one with the executive Mr. Mugg. Stay tuned, folks.
Give his word and he'd give his hand that his Injun friends could keep their land. The rest of his life he took the stand that justice was due every redskin band. Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier. He went off to Congress and served a spell, fixing up the government and laws as well. Took over Washington, so we hear tell, and patched up the crack in the Liberty Bell. Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and will determine the number one contender for the FTC Cruiserweight Championship. Making his way to the ring from Gainesville, Georgia, the phenomenal Travis Delena. His opponent from Boston, Massachusetts, he is the King of Wrestling, Billy Paz. Alright, and this Cruiserweight competition is underway. Both of these men have been really impressive lately, Travis Delena and Billy Paz, and in the early going they're both squaring each other up. Both of these men have different styles in the ring. As you can see, they're different weight classes, but don't let that fool you, because it's all cruiserweight division here. And I think one thing that both of these men have in common is that they've both made, oh, look at this roll up right here. He could have it right here, folks. One. Oh, that's it. That's all it takes right there. Both of these men can say that they've made two different men suffer defeat at the hands of them. Billy Paz got two big wins and made it to the finals in the FTC tournament last week. Over the last 2 weeks, I should say, he beat Samoa Steve and Mitchell Gunn, I believe. And Travis Delena last week, he defeated Samoa Steve and Christopher Campbell in a big triple threat match. And both of them have a lot of right in this match. And what a nice enziguri by Billy Paz right there. Whoever the Kid has to face. Oh, nice drop kick right there. That's one of Travis Delena's signature moves, is his phenomenal drop kicks. And oh my God, oh, that was a... I thought that was going to be the Travis clash right there. And psychologically, that could be bad for Billy Paz, because he knows that it's that simple for him to... Oh, Sambo suplex, not exactly. You know, that's all it takes for him to hit his finisher. And another signature. Another nice drop kick right there by Travis Delena. Throws him against the ropes. Ooh, what a nice Samoan drop right there on the big man. The Kid had to defeat a different generation of light heavyweight superstars to get where he is, to become the Cruiserweight champion. And tonight, you know, this is the top of the top of a different generation. As we can see, Travis Delena and Billy Paz, both of these men really impressive. And it's just going to be a matter of the Brainbuster versus... Oh, what a nice drop kick. It's going to be a matter of the Brainbuster versus the Travis clash, whoever gets their finisher move first. Oh, what a big miss right there. And that could take a lot out of the tank for Billy Paz. It's going to be hard for him to recover from that one, but I wouldn't doubt that he could. Oh, what a nice counter right there. Drop kick to the back of the head. And oh man, if he softens the back of the head up, oh man, he's going for that DDT. He really wants to, you know, cause a lot of damage to the upper area. And if he does that, then the Brainbuster is going to be, you know, right in the bag. It's going to be, you know, nothing harder than that. And what's this? No way. Oh, the Brainbuster, just as I said it right there. So much damage. No way. Oh, the moonsault. That's got to be it. One, two. Oh, my God. How did he kick out? Travis Delena, somehow, folks, showing all the resilience in the world. That's just, I'm beside myself right there. I don't think I've ever seen anybody kick out of Billy Paciencia's Brainbuster. And, you know, with all the damage to the brain, to the head area especially, you know, you gotta see the resilience And Travis Delena has a lot of fight in him because he knows what's on the line tonight. And, oh, backdrop driver, that has got to be the end, folks. He's going to the top. Oh, the splash, it's over. 1, 2, 3, what? Oh my God, Travis Delena still in this contest. I don't know how he's doing it. Coming back somewhere out of nowhere. He hit the head scissors. And this could be it. He lifts him up. Gets him up. Oh, Travis Clash, folks. That has got to be it. 1, 2, 3. What a match. Oh.
Here is your winner. And the number one contender for the FTC Cruiserweight Championship. Travis Delena.
And what good back and forth action. Devinger is going to win this match. Hitting predicaments back and forth. You know, with all the damage, with all the back and forth action, signature maneuvers, finisher maneuvers. I thought it was over. The Brain Buster. Oh my God, the moonsault halfway across the ring. That should have been it. But somewhere, out of nowhere, Travis Delena. Look at this from another angle right there. What an impressive Travis Clash. He celebrated. What is this? That's the champion. The kid is here tonight, folks. Oh my God. The blindside attack. This is uncalled for right here. Oh my God. Sending repeated shots. He's got him in the corner. Are you kidding me? Oh, the top rope Hurricane Rana. Combination. Oh my God. Disgusting. The champion is in the building and he is sending a message to the number one contender, sending him to the outside. And this Portland crowd does not like it.
I can understand why the number one contender to my Cruiserweight Championship has come after me. Because I'm the cream of the crop in the company. And I am the best wrestler in the company. Because I am straight edge. He's out there partying all night. Doing drugs. Doing God knows what. That's why he's not a champion. That's why he's not me. I am straight edge, and look how far it's gotten me in the company. I am the best wrestler. I am a champion. Unlike him being a talented jobber, I've seen Ultimate Warrior. Ultimate Warrior has more talent than you. And that's saying something for the Warrior. Just wait. At the pay-per-view, I will come right up to you and bring the straight edge to you because I am better than you. And after... maybe after I beat you 1, 2, 3 and retain my title, maybe you see the way of straight edge. Maybe you follow the straight edge lifestyle, and maybe one day you can become a champion too. But till then, I got your ass in the ring anytime. Because I'm straight edge, and I'm the best in the company. So if you're not with the straight edge, get with it.
I'm backstage with David Starr. David, you really fell on hard times last week at the hands of 420 Goonie, but it seems as if this week you really pick yourself up going into your first FTC pay-per-view in a title match against not only the champion Texas Tommy, but your opponent from earlier tonight, Mitchell Gunn. How do you feel right now?
Hey, Cole. Hey, alright. Listen, Michael. I just had a big match. Just had a big match, okay? So just give me a minute. Alright. Alright. So things didn't go as planned between me and Mitchell. We tied. Ironman match. But I'll definitely say that the stars were definitely out tonight. I couldn't do it without you guys out there. My stars. That's right, that's right. Now, as for last week and what happened between Vaughn and the 420 Goonie, I'm going to let that one go because I'm focused on something else. You see, I'm just prolonging that for a future goal. But right now, it's time for David Starr to go hardcore. Over and out.
Thanks for those words, and good match earlier. Back to you guys. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Tokyo, Japan, the red belt, Reggie Tillar. And his opponent from Clarksville, Tennessee, representing Southern Comfort, the executive, Mr. Mugg. And what a heated contest we have for you right now. A battle that has been going on since week one, folks. Reggie Tillar and Mr. Mugg for the second time, 2 weeks in a row right here. This is the third time actually. They went one-on-one on week one, but man, Reggie Tillar is pissed off. He has vengeance. He has revenge on his mind right here because, you know, Mr. Mugg screwed him last week out of that win. And, well, that's one way to think about it. He hit him real hard with that chair, and it was just utter brutality. He had to resort to using the chair to beat him because he couldn't do it with his own finisher. And ever since then, Reggie Tiller's just been mad. He's been making a point. And, you know, when you heard that promo from him last week, you can really hear the tone in his voice that he wants revenge. And oh, face first into the palm. That has got to hurt right here. And this crowd's going crazy right here. This is one of the craziest feuds we've ever seen. One of the longest lasting, probably the longest lasting feud we've ever had here in FTC. And you know, I mean, both of these men want each other's blood. They both want to kill each other. And you know, that's probably what we're gonna see tonight. And oh, what a nice crossbody by the red belt, Reggie Tillar. Oh, and it seems like he's taking every opportunity that he can. He's bashing his head in. I mean, he's hitting them high flying. He's going all over the place. And Mr. Mugg just trying hard right here to get himself, oh, nice forearm smash to the lower back right there. He's trying to get himself some momentum in his direction. But Reggie Tillar, oh, face first into the turnbuckle. And that has a lot of damage. Oh, one, two. Oh, I thought that was it right there. Oh, the right into the turnbuckle. So much damage to the face right there. And what's Reggie Tillar? Oh my god, the combination. Kick to the back of the head. What brutality by the red belt. And he looks pissed off right here. And he grabs the executive. And what's he doing? He's pulling him to the center of the ring. And oh, the rear naked choke. Chokeholds are not allowed in FTC, folks. Oh my god, he's trying to reach the ropes, but oh, wait a minute. The bell rings. He never tapped out.
Here is your winner, Reggie Tillar.
He never tapped out. Look at this, folks. Oh, the rope's in the way. Let's get another angle. Can we get another angle on this? Here we go. Okay, so look, he's trying to get to the ropes. He's choking him out, folks. Look at this. Look at this brutality right here. And you don't see him tap out. You never see him give up, folks. Look at this. He just passes out. What do we do? What do we do? You can't win. Wait a minute. This match is over. What the hell is Reggie Tillar doing? Oh, my God. He just dropped him on the back of his head. Oh my god, Mr. Mugg is knocked out. Oh my goodness, what brutality by Reggie Tillar.
I don't believe what I just saw back there. We still got a lot more action for you tonight, folks. After the break, Ryan Carroll and Sokka 105 take on Tony Free and Triple D. The winners are going to face Southern Comfort for the FTC Tag Team Championships at No Mercy. Texas Tommy's been gone the last couple of weeks, but tonight he says he will make up for his absence and steal the show tonight when he goes one-on-one with a mystery opponent. Who is it? We don't know. He doesn't even know who his opponent is. Before the break, we all saw this attack by Reggie Tillar. I don't know where the hell this came from, but he knocked Mugg out after their match right there.
Yo, man, this is some motherfucking bullshit. 3 weeks ago, I was the number one contender for the FTC Championship, and now I'm stuck facing this dweeb in a karate outfit. So help me God, if I see Reggie Tillar backstage, I'ma whoop your ass. And if Southern Comfort sees you backstage, they gon' whoop your ass too. And I don't need you disturbing me of achieving my goal of becoming the next FTC champ.
That's what you got.
This is it. Every week you two going at it. At this rate, it'll never stop. FTC doesn't have enough room for the two of you, so I'm gonna put an end to this once and for all. At No Mercy, it's gonna be you, Mr. Mugg, going one-on-one with Reggie Tillar in a first blood match. He who bleeds first gets fired.
What?
Hopefully this should end everything.
I don't believe this.
You know, this reminds me of a story from when I was just a young lad. About the age of 20, to be exact, I was living in a small town called...
All you hear is music hitting, this crowd's going wild right now. It's the number one contender for the FTC Championship, Vaughn Hollywood. Oh, and him and Vince McMahon just bumped shoulders. Wait a minute, he just tiger suplexed him on the stage. Oh my goodness.
I arrived in 420 CAW a few months ago, and a few months later, I've been the most talked about, I've been the most wanted man on the roster. This beautiful city of Portland, Oregon's been showing me love, and I've been showing you love back. I came to this federation, betrayed my own brother, took his hoe, made her my Hollywood hoe, and now my main goal is to dethrone the so-called king in the 420 Goonie. 420 Goonie, I do respect you. If it wasn't for you, none of us would be here right now. But we all know you're crooked as shit. So my job at No Mercy is to dethrone the champion, take that belt, and bring back real wrestling. Because ever since you've been taking over this federation, hell has been running loose, and I'm tired of it. You've been the referee, the commentator, the booker, the writer. Last week, I didn't have to lift a finger when I beat David Starr. All thanks to you. You think I'm not tired of that? You think these fans out here aren't tired of that? 420 Goonie, your days are numbered. Why? This is destiny. I'm a rookie here. This is my first year here, and I've been the most talked about. I deserve that title shot. I earned that title shot in the tournament, and come No Mercy, that's the day it all ends for the so-called King of CAW, 420 Goonie. And I can't wait to whip that ass at No Mercy, take that belt, make it the Hollywood belt, go to the Hollywood Hotel in Portland, Oregon, and party like it's no tomorrow. Because after I whip your ass, it's gonna be a new era in FTC. You could bank on that. Now that's Hollywood.
Vaughn Hollywood, let's get something clear. I don't like you. I don't like your persona. I don't like your demeanor. I don't like your attitude. And I especially don't like this ego you've grown over the last few weeks. You know, this company was just fine before you came around. I'm the best thing FTC has going for it right now. As long as I'm running the show around here, you will never become FTC champion. Never! Come on, Rock, let's get him.
Oh my god, are you kidding me? This is fucking pathetic right here. Oh my god, The Rock and Goonie stomping away at Vaughn Hollywood. Oh my god, their match is in just like 20, no, their match is in like 10 or 15 minutes right here. This is unfair. Look at this, The Rock, now the center of the ring, no! Are you kidding me? Rock bottom! Oh my god, what an unfair assault right here, and the 420 Goonie with the Goonie Crusher. Oh my god, and Vaughn Hollywood is lying, he's just laid out right here, he's laid out in the middle of the ring, and look at Goonie celebrate. What a piece of shit champion. This was an unfair assault. There's your champion, folks. Joining me at this time is Mitchell Gunn. Mitchell, let me be the first to congratulate you on your match earlier. You didn't come up with the victory, but you put out just a good enough performance for our hardcore champion Texas Tommy to see something in you, and you're going into the next pay-per-view into the hardcore title match. How do you feel about this?
Well, Michael, I didn't get done what I wanted to in that match. But it's okay, because I have another chance to do that at No Mercy. Next week, I'm gonna prove that I'm the best, and bring that hardcore title home to the Northwest.
Thanks for those words, and good luck at the pay-per-view. Back to you guys. The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall, and will determine the number one contenders for the FTC Tag Team Championships. Making their way to the ring, Tony Free and Triple D. And their opponents from Baltimore, Maryland, at a total combined weight of 450 pounds, FTC Censorship.
Alright, and this big tag team contest is underway. Here we can see it's Sokka 105 starting it off for FTC Censorship, and for the STD of FTC. For the other team, it's Triple D starting off for their team, and here in the early going, we see a nice hurricane run up there by the light heavyweight. Oh man, and look at the tag team effort right here we see by these two, and that is what it takes here in the tag team division. Both of these teams have seen a lot of success over the last couple of weeks. It was Tony Free and Triple D. They beat former, 20-time champions, I think it was, something like that, the Dudley Boys. You know, they whooped a lot of ass right there. And a nice fresh tag right there we see. Oh, what a nice drop kick right there by Ryan Carroll as he makes his way into this match. They're going to put it all on the line tonight and, you know, really bring the tag team division to the next generation, because all of these men, something everyone in FTC wants is those tag team titles to be off of the current champions, which are... Oh, and Triple D barely gets the rope break. If he wouldn't have, Ryan Carroll would have ripped that arm out of socket and probably beat him with it right there. This team is just absolutely crazy right here. And while they're crazy, they represent Censorship along with it, and, you know, they really don't get the fans on their side while they do it. Oh, what a nice splash right there. One, two, oh, and he breaks it up. What good action right there. Thanks to Tony Free right there breaking it up and making this contest go on. But like I was saying, everyone wants Southern Comfort to lose those tag team titles. And look at this, oh my god, oh, the Doomsday, oh, to the back of the head off the top rope. I don't believe this. Could he be going for another splash? He hits a splash right there. I don't believe this. One, two, three.
Here are your winners, and the number one contenders for the FTC Tag Team Championships, FTC Censorship.
Look at another camera angle right there. Oh, absolutely beautiful. And it puts him away. And it's going to be FTC Censorship against Southern Comfort. And speaking of the Devils, here they are.
Y'all two white boys know what y'allselves getting into, right? Ain't no way in hell Shad and I are losing our tag team titles to a couple of white boys like you two. You know, that's the problem with FTC lately. All these no-name tag teams coming out the woodwork trying to climb up the food chain, trying to get what we got. Who's gonna buy the pay-per-view with y'all on it? These people would rather see the Hardy Boys or the Dudleys. Now you two honky motherfuckers. You two are dead at No Mercy, if you make it there. Because at No Mercy, you will feel some Southern Comfort.
For those of you who don't know who I am, for those of you who don't have a wanted list in your city, for those of you who don't watch the news, I'm yours truly, J-Crack, the Prince of Destruction, the Hardcore Kid, the King of Blood, the Jeffrey Dahmer of professional wrestling, J-Crack. How you doing, busy girl? How you doing? Alright. Let's get down to business. Why I'm here in FTC. Why I'm here getting ready to run amok. A reign of havoc in FTC. What does FTC stand for, busy girls? Fuck that shit. It's all about me. It's all about fucking that chick. Okay, I'm playing, but that's not what it stands for. But that's not the point, boys and girls. The point is this. I'm getting ready to make my mark. And by making my mark, I mean leaving a path of destruction wherever I go. For those of you who's going to be in the ring with me, well, let's just say that, quite frankly, you're fucked. You're totally fucked. Because I'm going to make you my bitch. I'm going to make you my personal little bitch. I am, you know. It sucks, but hey, that's how life works. Going to ruin me, most likely you're going to bleed. Most likely you're going to cry. Most likely you might end up being dead. Okay, not dead. Just severely maimed. Boys and girls. I can't wait to have fun at FTC. I can't wait to fuck shit up. I cannot wait, boys and girls of FTC. I cannot wait at all. I'm gonna kill everyone in FTC. Quote the crack. No. That's not it. That's right. Have a nice day, boys and girls of FTC. Peace.
The following hardcore contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Austin, Texas, the FTC Hardcore Champion, Texas, Tommy!
And it's the moment of truth. The anticipation is killing everyone here in Portland tonight.
No way! Could it be? It's him! Shane O'Mac is here in FTC! And this crowd is going apeshit right now! Oh my god, what a match this is gonna be! The hardcore champion going one-on-one with Shane McMahon! Oh my god, this is gonna be absolutely crazy right here! Oh my god, Shane McMahon! Oh, he's had a crazy history. Former WWF Hardcore Champion. Oh man, if he could pick up a big victory tonight, maybe he could get himself involved in the big triple threat match. Maybe make it a fatal four way in a couple of nights at No Mercy. But you know, he's had a huge path of destruction behind him at WWF. He's taken out the Big Show. He's taken out The Rock. He's taken out X-Pac. He's taken out everybody with the help of, oh my god, big Tope elbow suicida right there, and he missed it big time, and Shane McMahon's gonna look to capitalize, and he smashes the hardcore champion's face into the ring apron right there, and there's no give, and he hits him a second time onto the table right there, and he throws him back first into those steel steps, and the hardcore champion knows what it feels like to get thrown into those steel steps, because over the last few weeks, oh my god, ever since week two, him and Rob Van Dam holding it down for the hardcore division, doing what they gotta do, and it's just been highly impressive. And look at Shane McMahon, vertical suplex on the steel steps. Absolutely impressive by the former WWF Hardcore Champion. And he says, hell no, champ, we're gonna keep this outside. And he's going for the pin on the outside, but no, he didn't even let it get to a one count right there. What intense action right here. Man, if you thought you saw a good hardcore match earlier right here, these men take it to the next level right here. And Texas Tommy and Rob Van Dam used to put on some good matches.
And oh my god, he's throwing him onto my table. I'm getting out of here. Look at, what the hell are they going to do to my table right here? Shane McMahon. Oh, and look at these signature punches. We've seen these before. I think he might have just knocked our champion out right here. He's laid out. He's laid out right here. And oh, he's climbing the ladder. What is this ladder doing right here? No, big elbow drop. He missed the elbow drop. Shane McMahon missed that signature elbow drop through the announce table. We've seen him do it many times to many people. And Tommy, oh my god. Oh my god, the Dominator on the thin mat. And trust me, that mat right here, it's just a thin pad, folks. It's an eighth of an inch, it's a quarter of an inch, it might be a half an inch, I don't know. But it's really thin. And look at this instant replay. Oh my god, Shane McMahon is hurting right here. He just took a lot of damage to the outside, and my table is gone. I'm going to have to get it rebuilt in between here and the next match, because, you know, it's probably going to show up in the next match, you know. So I need to announce that it's going to be built, you know what I'm saying. But what a hardcore match we have seen. The hardcore champion, Texas Tommy, really having this match and his momentum right here, and the hardcore division really being brought to the next level. And what could he be going for? Oh my god, he's grabbing him by his head. Oh my god, the DDT to the back of the head. 1, 2, 3, what a matchup.
Here's your winner, the FTC Hardcore Champion, Texas Tommy.
Look at this match, hardcore from the very beginning. And oh, when he missed that, Shane McMahon was able to get himself a fairly nice amount of momentum. And he missed it with that elbow drop. He put a lot of men away with that elbow drop. And Texas Tommy came back with that scorpion death drop right to the back of the head. Oh my god, what brutality. Now that was an impressive matchup. And our main event is sure to be just as impressive. Vaughn Hollywood for the first time going one-on-one with the Great One.
Great match, Ryan. Those tag titles are as good as ours. I'm gonna go grab a few pizzas. I'll be right back.
Hey, Ryan Carroll. I wanted to apologize about what I said earlier. Shad and I thought about it. And we're happy that you won that match. As a matter of fact, we came back to celebrate. Come on, Shad. Let's lift Ryan Carroll in the air and celebrate on his big win.
Wait a minute. Look at this. They're not... Oh my god, they're not celebrating with him. They just drove him onto the concrete. Double powerbomb. What brutality by the champions. And they're going to do everything they can to make sure that Ryan Carroll and Sokka 105 do not make it to No Mercy. Look at this. No. The two tables, no. Oh, the double backdrop. Oh my god.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is your main event of the evening. Making his way to the ring, from Hollywood, California, Vaughn Hollywood!
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking?
His opponent, from Miami, Florida, weighing 275 pounds, The Rock!
And it's main event time in Portland, Oregon, folks. Vaughn Hollywood going one-on-one with the Great One for the first time. And The Rock says, just bring in the early going right here. And ever since Goonie made the announcement at the end of the main event, you know, last week on Monday Night Raw, this has been a match we've all been waiting to see. And both of these men are, you know, highly decorated athletes, especially in the wrestling world. And this is a match that you're not going to see anywhere else except for here on Monday Night Raw. And God, what momentum this could give Vaughn Hollywood right here if he can pick up the victory tonight against a 10-time champion, the current WWE champion. Well, while I'm saying this, you know, who knows if he'll be while this is uploaded, but he is right now. And look at The Rock. He got it taken to him in the early going, and he's stepping to the outside. Veteran maneuver on his part. And he's taking a second to think about his game plan and, you know, really, you know, switch things up for a second. So, you know, it's kind of taken into the second wave of this match right here. Vaughn Hollywood's had a
a string of impressive victories over the last couple of weeks. You know, he's beaten Spinnernet. He beat the bad guy in a ladder match at the last CPV. That was impressive. He beat Mr. Mugg in the first round. He beat David Starr in the second round. He beat Billy Paz in the finals. And it leads us to tonight. Man, what a match this is going to be. And he, oh my God. What a vertical suplex right there by The Rock. And that's a move that Vaughn looks to put people away with right there. So, you know, that could have taken a lot out of the number one contender, I should say. These two men exchanging shots right here in the ring. And this crowd's going wild right here. Oh my God. Exchanging shots. I kind of like when that goes down, especially here on WWF No Mercy. FTC No Mercy, I should say. Tomorrow night, going to be one of the biggest events of all time. Vaughn Hollywood going one-on-one with the 420 Goonie in the main event for the FTC Championship. Also, we just found out a little bit ago that, FTC Censorship is going to be the number one contenders for the FTC Tag Team Champions. FTC Tag Team Championships, I should say. And the card is really looking to shape up nicely, but I don't think any match is going to be more highly anticipated than what, Vaughn and Goonie are going to put on, because that's going to be a crazy match right here. It seems like everybody's kind of pissed off with what Goonie's been doing, and Vaughn's been the only person to really be able to stand up and, you know, take charge and beat everybody's ass that says that he shouldn't be doing while he's doing. And, that could also include The Rock here tonight. Vaughn Hollywood undefeated here. I believe he is in FTC. If he's not, you know, don't. I'm pretty sure he is. Look at The Rock. Oh my God, what a nice backdrop right there. Now both of these men haven't really had too much momentum in either of their direction, but The Rock wrenching on the head right here, that could take a lot out of Vaughn Hollywood right here. And if The Rock takes a lot out of the upper part of Vaughn right here, then it looks like another rock bottom could, you know, put him away real quickly, because as we all saw, he hit him with a rock bottom earlier. Goonie hit him with a Goonie Crusher. He hit him with the championship. What a poor display by the champion, but it's all you can expect by that stupid son of a bitch. I can't stand that motherfucker, and I hope he's not the champion after No Mercy, but I guess we're going to find out in a couple of nights. And look at The Rock. Oh my God, another vertical suplex. Like I said earlier, Vaughn usually uses that move to put people away, but, you know, oh, European uppercut. Oh, but The Rock looks fired up. And oh my God, no. Another rock bottom, the second rock bottom of the night, the first of the match, hooks the leg, one, two, oh my God, count two, oh my goodness, second rock bottom of the night, I thought he had him right there, folks, what, oh my God, every single person in this crowd, anyone that was sitting, no one's sitting down, but anyone that was probably on the edge of their seat, everyone is standing up and going wild right here tonight, 18,420 strong. One of the bigger main events we've ever seen in Monday Night Raw. I think the biggest we've ever seen was week one when we crowned our first champion, Goonie. Not to be, you know, biased against the owner or anything like that, not to get myself fired, you know, but, I just think it was a huge moment to crown the champion, and we may crown a new champion. What a superplex by The Rock right there. We could crown a new champion in a couple of weeks, and Rock looks to follow it up. High-risk maneuver, top rope, and he's taunting him. Oh my God, he says that. Oh, and he misses big time. A lot of damage to the leg right there. Oh my God. Vaughn Hollywood could look to capitalize right here. The momentum may have just swung into the arms of the number one contender for the FTC Championship. Oh my God, he looks to damage the leg. I don't know if it was the same leg that he just hit. But high risk maneuver himself. Oh, and he misses the elbow drop. Both of these men missing their top rope maneuvers. Oh man, what the hell is going on? The momentum swinging back and forth. A third vertical suplex by the Great One. Oh man, he could look to put this match away right here. Oh my God. Oh, the spine buster. I don't believe it. And yeah, he's going for the most electrifying move in sports entertainment today. The people's elbow. I don't believe it. No one kicks out of this. Center of the ring. One, two, three. What a match. Here is your winner, The Rock.
take another look at that other right there. They don't call electrifying for nothing. Vaughn Hollywood, he suffered way too much damage tonight. Not only to the mob, but he's doing. Wait a minute. Oh my god, no, I don't. Oh my god. Here he comes, the FTC champion, the Gooey. Here he comes for this championship, and it's him, and it's The Rock in the ring. And they're celebrating their win tonight. Is this going to be a sign of things to come in FTC? How is things going to change? We're going to find out in a couple of nights at No Mercy. Tune in, folks. Thanks for watching from Portland, Oregon.